2008, before the economy collapsed and George Carlin died and Sarah Palin became a household word, I lived in a cute little gingerbread house right around the corner from the I Dream of Weenie hot dog stand. You know the place. Well, anyway, everything was swell with my happy, happy family in our gingerbread house, except for the undeniable fact that every single day, 24/7, I made a whole lot of noise playing the drums. A loud freaking drums! Every day and night, I was driving everyone crazy. So I got on Craigslist and I typed in houses with recording studios inside them. And would you believe it, I found about 150 of them. So I said to my sweet wife, how would you like to come house hunting with me? And she said, what? I can't hear you! I guess all the drumming had made her a little deaf. Well, we took a snare drum and a drumstick and we went from house to house. And inside each house, she beat on that snare drum as hard as she could. And if I could hear it outside, we went on to the next house. Until finally we found the perfect home with finished pine floors and walls that were oh so soundproof. And I asked the guy what he wanted for it and he told me and I said, okay, but you have to throw in that Murray riding mower I see out back. And he said, sure, waka waka doo doo, yeah. Well, let me tell you people, that Murray riding mower was my dream come true, and it was about to become my new best friend. Back at the old house, I'd been mowing the lawn with a push mower, and that yard was huge, and I was always miserable. So it was amazing when I realized, after the home loan went through, that I now had a new special friend, my pal, the Murray
riding mower.
My pal, the Murray
lawn tractor.
See, I'd never even been on a riding mower before, and I gotta tell you, it was really great. But here's the thing. The folks who were about to buy our old house, well, they were really excited to live there, and one day before that sale was final, I went by the old house to check the mail, and I found the new owners-to-be in the backyard planting geraniums. I didn't want to be a jerk, because it's not like they were writing on the walls with poop or anything, but still, they didn't own the house yet. So I said, hey, no big deal, but if you want to work in the yard, give me a call first, okay? And they looked embarrassed. You know why? I'll tell you why.
Cause the sale hadn't closed, so technically they were trespassing. Cause the sale hadn't closed, so technically they were trespassing. Cause the sale hadn't closed, so technically they were trespassing.
How can that possibly come back and bite me on the butt? So I'm back at our new house, mowing the new lawn with my new best friend, Murray. He's awesome. This new yard has no trees to get in my way, and the property goes all the way around the house, so I can mow in great big circles without stopping for branches or roots or dilapidated flower boxes or bikes or roadside trash or used hypodermic needles or big flaming bottles of psoriasis ointment or anything! A few weeks pass, and the old house is about to sell. The real estate people call it closing. You know, I don't know why they call it closing. Why can't they call it selling, like any normal, halfway intelligent, English-speaking, carbon-based life form? Am I wrong here? Am I wrong? Anyway, then I realize I haven't mowed the lawn at the old house in nearly a month, and it's about to close. I think to myself, I should mow that lawn for the new owners, because I can't call and ask them to mow it, because I chewed them out for planting flowers. And then I think, I don't have a way to transport Murray, the riding mower, 8 miles from the new house to the old house. And then it hits me. I could drive Murray to the old house. Yeah, Murray goes, what, like 5 miles an hour? So I should get there in under 2 hours, mow the lawn in like 45 minutes, and get home in another 2 hours. What a delightful way to spend a day! Sure beats working. So I get on MapQuest and I plan my route, and I'm new to this part of town, so I don't know all the back roads yet. So I get a hat and some sunglasses and a potted fern and some rechargeable batteries and my catcher's mitt and a bag of raisins and my lucky, lucky autographed glow-in-the-dark snorkel and my cell phone. And finally, I'm ready to go. Then I realize I need to plan a gas stop on my route. I'd feel pretty stupid if I ran out of gas on a lawnmower, and AAA wouldn't help. You know what they'd say? They'd say, if you get yourself a car, we'd be glad to help you out. But we can't send a tow truck out to fix a lawnmower. If you get yourself a car, we'd be glad to help you out. But we can't send a tow truck out to fix a lawnmower.
Even your
pal, Murray. Your pal, Murray.
So I make sure I'm gonna pass at least one gas station, and I grab my credit card and all that other stuff, and at 8 a.m. I hit the road. I'm rolling along, and since it's probably illegal to drive a lawnmower on public streets, I pretend I'm mowing each lawn I pass. I soon realize, however, that this mower really goes about 3 miles an hour, so this is gonna be a longer excursion than I had planned. no problem. A rock star like me can take the whole day off if he wants. I make a wrong turn, I have to backtrack, and that costs me about a half an hour. Man, this thing is slow and loud. I never realized before how loud this mower is. I get a call from my attorney and stop the mower and talk to him about the closing coming up. Everything's fine, I'm still a big shot. And I start the mower and I go on. I come to a busy street and I take advantage of the sidewalk. I'm mowing the sidewalk, feeling good, and as I go along, a cement wall appears on my right. I've got a wall on my right, a curb and a busy street on my left, and suddenly I see, right in the middle of the sidewalk, a mailbox. Some jerk has planted a mailbox in the middle of the sidewalk, and I can't get around it. I have to back up a block and take Murray out in the street and drive that block again. And now I notice I have an audience for this part. The cast of King of the Hill is standing around staring at me. Hey, don't any of you guys have a job to go to? 2 hours in, I stop for gas, I whip out the credit card, put in $2 worth, and ignoring the laughter and cruel jokes from the other drivers around me, I head back out on the open road. You know, when you're only going 3 miles an hour on a really loud internal combustion vehicle and pretending to mow lawns, you notice some things that you might ordinarily overlook. Like how there are kids on school buses in the middle of the day, and they're way, way higher up than a schmuck on a lawnmower, and they're waving at me and making really unnecessarily rude gestures with their hands. Little things like that. Speaking of school, my route takes me by our kids' school. I hope to God they're not looking out the windows as I roar by 120 decibels at 3 miles an hour. I mean, that's just what I need. It's not bad enough that I've grossly underestimated the time commitment involved in this stupid plan, or that I forgot to put on my Old Spice stick deodorant this morning, or that I have a tiny bit of mint dental floss stuck between my upper right molars, which is driving me crazy, or that I just remembered that I have hay fever, and even though I'm just pretending to mow all these lawns, the pollen is way up in my cerebral cortex now, and all I can do is sneeze into the wind and pretend I have a handkerchief the size of a tablecloth at the Sizzler. Now I gotta worry about the kids' friends tormenting them for years to come about their idiot parental unit who is driving by on a really loud lawnmower in a stupid hat. I'm hot, I'm tired, I'm ready to mow the lawn at the old house and get done what I came to do. I'm getting closer. I can see the old place. It's right up there. Oh man, there it is. And as I arrive 4 hours after setting out, I see the new owner-to-be, and he's just finished mowing the lawn. And I said, whoa, what the? Are you kidding me? And he said, I guess I should have called you. And your pal, Murray. Your pal, Murray. We both felt pretty stupid. We just stared at the newly cut grass and at the two lawnmowers, and at the 27 8x10 color glossy photographs with the circles and arrows to be used as evidence against us, and at the two lawnmowers. I said, I have to mow something! He said, well, I haven't done that fenced area in the back yet. I said, okay, I'll get that! And I drove the mower over there, and I realized that Murray wouldn't fit through the gate! So I mowed that area with the bush mower. I thought, I gotta mow something. I took Murray over to a patch of grass by the alley, and little did I know that sticking up from the ground through the long grass was a steel rod. And I hit that steel rod, and the mower stopped. It died with a very unsatisfying crunch. I did get it started again, but the part of the mower that actually cuts grass was no longer working. Now I was driving a very loud go-kart. It was the Mr. Bean moment of my life. And I had a 4 hour really loud trip home ahead of me. Another chance for the kids to see me driving a lawnmower in front of their friends. More school buses full of nasty staring monsters and the very real possibility of getting lost or running out of gas. And that evil mailbox just waiting for me. Oh man, I hate it when I'm stupid. And now, years later, when I'm driving around with friends in the car, I show them the root of ultimate stupidity. You see that? That's where I pretended to mow that fat guy's lawn. There's where I had to go down that 45-mile-an-hour curve stretch with no sidewalk, hoping not to get hit by a truck. There's that mailbox I wound up setting on fire. There's where I had heat stroke and threw a rod and accidentally put borscht in the gas tank. But I guess the whole point I'm trying to make here is... I hate geraniums! That's all I'm really trying to say. And by the way, if one day you happen to be making some kind of exciting real estate deal, unloading a piece of crap gingerbread house to get a goofy-looking barn type of a house with a recording studio in it so that you can play the drums all night long, just make sure that your new house is a sweet little home. A little place with a new friend that makes a lot of noise. Like my pal, Marie.
Play drums.